Hello everyone, and welcome to the Learn Services. So in this video I will talk about history of ancient India. Entire ancient Indian history will be covered in this video. All of the facts of ancient Indian history will be explained right here. So please be patient, it will take a little time to be interesting, but definitely you will get something out here. Okay, so let's see all facts. The Harappan fort is in the shape of parallel square, is 460 yards in length, north to south, 215 yards in breadth, east to west, and 15 to 17 yards in height. This is not that important, but I am telling you so that you can visualize what was the shape of Harappan fort. The script of Indus civilization was pictorial, in which there were more than 600 picture letters and 60 original letters. The excavation of Chanudaro were carried out in 1925 under the leadership of Ernest Mackay. So the excavation of Chanudaro were carried out in 1925 under the leadership of Ernest Mackay. This town had no fort. Nal, Daburakot, Rakhigadi, Banwali, Rangpur, Lothal, Desh Murasi, Kulli, Rana Gundai, Anjira, Gumla, Amri, Gundai, Mundigak, Dipla Bagh, Sahar e Sokta, Bampur, Quetta. These are the famous historical sites where the remains of Indus civilization and pre-Indus civilization have been excavated. Daburkot, Periano, Gundai, Kulli, Mehi, Chanudaro, Amri, Lom, Jaduraro, Alimurad, Ropar, Rangpur, Shutka Jindar are the most prominent spots, places of Indus Valley civilization. The excavation of Kali Bangan, a historical place in Rajasthan, began in 1961 under the direction of B.K. Thapar and B.B. Lal. From the lower layer of excavation, the remains of pre-Indus civilization, and from the upper layer of Indus civilization are discernible. The fortress and the city both were surrounded with walls. The excavation of Rangpur, an Indus site in Gujarat, were carried out in 1953-54 under the leadership of Rangnath Rao. Okay, forts of raw bricks, drainage, terracotta, utensils, weights and slabs of stone have been found, but the idol of mother goddess Matri Devi and coins have not been found. Lothal was situated at the time near the ocean. It is definitely at, you know, in Gujarat. In excavation, the remains of dockyard have been found, which testify to the trade relations of Indus people with Western Asia. Okay. In the district of Kutch in Gujarat state, 12 kilometers northeast of Adesar is situated Surkodda, which was explored and excavated in 1964 under the guidance of Jagatpati Joshi. Okay. In the excavation of Indus civilization, a very big building have been explored. It is 252 feet long and 112 feet broad. The walls are 5 feet thick. You can see wall was very thick. Some figurines on tables have been found in Indus civilization, in the center of which is a round shaped sun, and around it are the pictures of six gods arranged in a way that they appear as if they are the sun beams. This testifies to the worship of sun in the period. Okay. The proof of the existence of man-like beings are 1 crore to 20 lakhs year old. So this is the thing. In the Indian population, there are 4 basic racial sub-differences. These are Negrito, Austro, Australians, Caucasus, Mongoloids. Okay. In India, skeletons, human body in bones, Kankal, have been found in Sarai Nahar Rai near Allahabad, Bataikhor, and Lekhania. High in length, flat nose, and broad mouth are their characteristic. These belong to Mesolithic age. Okay. The pre-stone civilization came to be known in the region of River Sohan, a subsidiary of Sindhu. Hence it is called as a Sohan civilization. The Vatika poem in the form of Gandhas, axe, and Khandak, where its main implements. In Harappan culture, the worship of earth as goddess was in vogue, so it was very prevalent at the time. This is indicated by the idol of a woman with a plant growing out of her womb, along with elephants, rhinoceros, buffaloes, lions, and deers. The picture of yogi engraved on a seal, mohar, suggests the worship of Shiva in Harappan civilization. This god had three heads and he sat with crossed legs. Okay, the talismans obtained in large numbers indicate that the people of Harappan culture believed in witchcraft or the dead souls. These talismans were made of bronze and copper in the form of plate. In Harappan culture, the weight for measuring were 16 or of its multiplied number. So this is important, you need to remember this one. The dogs and cats were the domesticated animals, and their footprints confirm this fact. The remains of the horses have been found at Surkotda. Please do remember this one. The existence of the horse is not known from the upper layer of Mohenjo-daro excavation. The terracotta small figurines provide knowledge about it. The people of Lothal used rice in 1800 BC. As Sindh was one of the oldest region for cultivating cotton, the Greeks named it as a Sedon. Okay. In Harappan culture, silver was obtained from Afghanistan, Iran, South India. So silver was obtained from Afghanistan, Iran, South India, Arabia, and Balochistan. Gold was imported from Afghanistan and Persia. Okay. This stone large ward was brought from Badakhshan. Firoza was brought from Iran. Jeomani was brought from Maharashtra. Munga and redstone was brought from Saurashtra and Western India. And the precious green stone Panna was brought from Central Asia. The Ahar culture in Rajasthan belonged to the Copper Age. The houses were built of stone and a mixture of lime and soil. Paddy was cultivated and metal work in bronze were in vogue. So metal work in bronze were in vogue at the time. All these were the characteristics of this culture, which existed about 2000 BC. The remains of Malwa stone and bronze culture have been found in Nawda Toli, where the houses were built of mud, bamboo, and dry grass in a square and round shape. The terracotta utensils and agricultural products of wheat, oil seeds, pulses, masoor, and green and black gram are the characteristic of this culture. Okay, so wheat, oil seed, pulses, especially masoor, and green and black gram. Okay, mud, bamboo, and dry grass. The rishis, sages like Grishamad, Vishwamitra, Bharadwaj, Atri, and Vasishth composed the suktas or the Vedic mantras. Okay. The prominent female sages were Lopamudra, Ghosh, Sachi, and Paulume. Samveda is divided into three branches: Kotham, Raninya, Jamidya. Prominent among the Ayurveda Acharyas were Acharya Ashwini Kumar, Dhanvantari, Banabhatta, Shushrut, Madhav, Jivan, and Lulimraj. Okay, so these were famous Ayurveda Acharyas. Ayurveda is an Upaved of Rigveda. Dhanurved is Upaved of Yajurved. Gandharved is the Upaved of Samaved. Silpaved is the Upaved of Atharved. Rigved has two Brahmins, Atreya and Kaushitki. Krishna Yajurved has the Brahman Taitreya and Shukla Yajurved. Shukla Yajurved has the Satpat Brahman. Okay. So Krishna Yajurveda has the Brahman Taitreya and Shukla Yajurveda has the Satpat Brahman. The Brahmans of Samaveda are Tandav, Panchavish, Sadavish and Chandogya. The Aranyaks deals with the life, death and other serious themes. These are written and studied in the loneliness of the forest. So this is about Aranyaks. Aitreya and Kausitiki are the Aranyaks of Rigveda. The author of Aitreya was Mahidas. Aitreya and Kausitiki are the Aranyaks of Rigveda. Okay. Author of Aitreya was Mahidas Aitreya. And Taitreya Aranyak belongs to the Krishna Yajurveda. Samaveda and Atharveda have no Aranyaks. Please remember this one. Samaveda and Atharveda have no Aranyaks. Prominent among the Upanishads are Is, Ken, Kat, Prashna, Mundak, Mandak, Taitreya, Aitreya, Chandogya, Vrihadaranyaka, Shvetashvara, Kaushitiki, and Mahanarayana. So this is about prominent among the Upanishads. Okay. During the Rigvedic period, Nisk was an ornament for the neck. Karna Soban was an ornament for the ear. Nisk was the ornament for the neck. So remember this one. Nisk was an ornament for the neck. Karna Sob was an ornament for ear. And Kumbh was the ornament for the head. Okay. In the Rigvedic age, Aryans domesticated the cow, the buffalo, goat, horse, elephant and camel. Bhishas was the person who treated the sick people. Bhishas was the person who treated the sick people. The Rigvedic Aryans worshipped the sun as Savita, Mitra, Pushan and Vishnu. Sun was called the eyes of gods. And Agni was called as the mouth of gods. Agni was considered to the Purohit of Aryans. Okay. They thought that offering up the Yajna reaches to the gods through Agni. Varun was worshipped as a special god. In Rigveda, Usha, Sita, Prithvi, Aranivi, Ratri, Vak are worshipped as a goddess. Besides Rigveda, the reference of Sita as the goddess of agriculture is made in Gomil, Griha Sutra and Praskar Griha Sutra. Okay, Praskar Griha Sutra. The ancient idol of Ganesh saw his main weapons as Pas and Ankush. In the Rigvedic age, the traders were called as a Pani. They stole away the cattle of Aryans. Das or Dasyas were more hated than the Pani. Das or Dasyas were more hated than the Pani. They have been referred as a black complexioned, inauspicious and opposed to Yajnas. They were the worshippers of Fallus, Shishrandev. Okay. In the Rigvedic age, the cow was the backbone of economy. It was called as Aghanya. So cow was called as Aghanya, not to be killed. War has been referred as a Gavasthi, the guest as a Mohan, and the daughter as Duhiti. One Rik refers to the domestication of sheep. Okay. Rik refers to the domestication of sheep. Vasisht, who replaced Vishwamitra as Purohit of King Sudas, have been mentioned as adopted son of Urvashi and born of Vire of Mitra and Varuna on an earthen spot. So this is interesting. Vasisht, who replaced Vishwamitra as Purohit of King Suda, have been mentioned as adopted son of Urvashi and born of the Vire of Mitra and Varuna on an earthen spot. Ballabh and Taruksad were chieftains who lavishly donated to the Purohits and through their grace obtained respect and high place in the Aryan society. Ballab and Tarukshadas. Savitri is referred in the famous Gayatri Mantra. In Rigveda, the maximum reference is made of Indra. After him, Varuna is referred to. In the earlier Richas, Varuna and Marut have been mentioned as Gana. Twast also was a Vedic god. Prajapati has been referred as the Adipurus, the first human male. Prajapati, the gods were his children. Okay, so this was Prajapati. In the Rigveda, the king has been mentioned as the protector of the clan or the Gopta Janas. The reference to Sabha, Samiti, Gana, Vidath is made as the tribal councils. No bureaucracy developed in Rigvedic is, yet the officer of Gochar land were called Vrajapati. The officer of the village was called as a Gramini. He was the commander. The chief of the family is referred as a Kulappa. The words like Vrat, Jan, Gram and Srad have been used for indicating the group of soldiers. The god of vegetation. It was also an intoxicating drink, and the method of its preparation is referred in the Rigveda. The later Vedic literature was written during 1100 to 600 BC. The painted graveware, bowls and plates were used, and the tools which they used were made of iron. So this is one of the most important thing about the Aryans. The main crop of the later Vedic age was wheat and paddy instead of barley. So the main crop of the later Vedic age was wheat and paddy instead of barley. In the later Vedic age, the Vidath was extinct, but the Sabha and Samiti existed. In this period, the king performed the rites of Rajasui Yajna with a desire to obtain divine power, Ashwamedh Yajna to expand the empire, and the Vajpayee Yajna for the chariot racing with friends and relatives of his Gotra. The Gotra system began in the later Vedic age. The custom of marrying outside the Gotra also started. In the literature of later Vedic age, the first three ashrams are mentioned: Brahmachari, Grihastra, Vanaprastha, and the Sannyas ashram is not mentioned. In later Vedic period, the plant Som could not be obtained easily, as such other drinks were also used. Gold and silver were mainly used for making ornaments and utensils. Other metals were used for making many other implements in the later Vedic era. In later Vedic period, the commercial classes, traders, organized themselves in Sangha. The Aryans conducted sea trade. Nisk, Satnam and Krishal were used as coins for trade purposes. In comparison to the religion of Rig Vedic period, the later Vedic religion had become very complex. Purohitas, yajna and sacrifice were considered important. Many type of yajnas were performed. The Satpat Brahman refers to the various steps in the progress of cultivation. Jutai means plowing. Bhuvai, okay. Planting. Bhuvai means planting. Okay. Lavani means weaning. Mandai means cutting. Are the various processes mentioned in it. Okay. Sangam literature is compiled in 8 books. They are the Narun, Kurtung. Maybe my pronunciation may not be right. I am sorry for that. If I am not right, make it correct. Agunuru, Padir Pittu, Paripadal, Kurlitorga, Nedulogt, Purunaru. In the Sangam age, the Tamil grammar was written in the detailed book Tolkappiyam. This is one of the most important Tamil grammar, Tolkappiyam. Please do remember this one. This is very important. With the songs of the musicians, the dancers known as Panar and Vaidliyar used to dance. Pedi Nelik Kenku is famous composition of Sangam literature. Sangam is a Sanskrit word meaning a congregation and council. The main thing of Sangam literature is romance, Sringar, and heroism, Veer Gatha. Sringar is called as Aham, and Veer Gatha has been called as a Puram. The first Sangam was organized at Madurai under the chairmanship of Rishi Agastya. The second Sangam was organized at Kapatpuram, again under the chairman of Rishi Agastya. The third Sangam was organized at Madurai and was chaired by Nakirar. Ayave was the family of Sangam age, which meant Sabha, means assembly. Panchvaram was the assembly of the advisors of the king of Sangam age. Ur was the institution which looked after the city administration. The excavation of Arik Medu provided enough evidence to prove that once upon a time, the cantonments of Roman traders resided there. The teachers in the Sangam age were called as a Kankatas. Students in the Sangam age were called as a Bhavan or Pillai. Okay, so Pillai. The Pashnath arranged for fourfold vows, Chaturvrat for the bhikshus, means monks. Pashnath. So what was the fourfold vows? I shall not kill the living beings. I shall always speak the truth. This is very important, please do remember this one. I shall always speak the truth. I shall not steal. I shall not keep any property. Mahavir Swami has been called Nigas, Nathputra and Nirgrant Satputra. Mahavir Swami left his mortal frame and attained Nirvana at Pavapuri near Patna in Bihar. The Triratna in Jainism are described as Samyak Shraddha, veneration, Samyak Gyan, means knowledge, and Samyak Acharana, means conduct. According to Jainism, Nirvana, redemption to free the soul from the physical bondage. Okay, Nirvana to free the soul from the physical bondage. This is the Nirvana in Jainism. Mahavir Swami has described five vows for the common people, which are called as the Panch Mahavrat. These are truth, non-violence, non-stealing, no collection of wealth or anything, and celibacy, Satya, Ahimsa, Astey, Aparigraha, and Brahmacharya. Brahmacharya was added by Mahavira. To these was later added not to eat at night. Okay. So this is the philosophy of Jainism. Kaival is total knowledge with the Nirgrantiket. Buddha was born in the Lumbini forest, 14 km beyond Kapilvastu in Nepal, Tarai. Kaundinya, a Brahmin astrologer, was contemporary of Buddha. Gautama obtained knowledge at Gaya, hence the place is called Bodh Gaya. The first sermon of Buddha is known as Dharma Chakra Pravartan. So first sermon of Buddha is known as Dharma Chakra Pravartan. Mahatma Buddha delivered his first sermon at Rishipatan Sarnath. The followers of Buddha were divided into four sections. Bhikshu are the monks. Bhikshuni are lady monks. Upasaks are devotees. Upasikas are lady devotees. After delivering his teachings for constant 45 years, Mahatma Buddha attained Mahaparinirvana at the age of 80 at Kushinara, means Kushinagar. Tripitakas are Vinayapitaka, Shutapitaka, Abhidhammapitaka. Vinayapitaka is divided into three sections, Sut Vibhag, Khandak, and Parivar. Sutapitaka contains Dighi Nikaya, Majjhima Nikaya, Anguttara Nikaya, and Kuddak Nikaya. In Abhidhamma Pitaka, philosophical and spiritual thoughts are contained. There are seven treatises of Abhidhamma Pitaka: Dhamma Sangit, Vibhanga, Dhatu Katha, Pugal Panjati, Katha Vastu, Yamak, and Pathan. The Eightfold Paths are right belief, right thought, right speech, right action, right means of livelihood, right execution, right remembrance, right meditation. So the Eightfold Paths are right belief, right thought, right speech, right action, right means of livelihood, right execution, right remembrance, and right meditation. In Buddhism, The Ashtangik Marg, the Eightfold Path, is classified as Prajaskand, Silaskand, Samadhiskand. Under Prajaskand come Samyak Drishti, Samyak Sankalp, and Samyak Vani, speech. Under Silaskand come Samyak Karman, Samyak Ajyam. Samyak Samadhi Skand kam Samyak Vyayam, Samyak Smriti, and Samyak Samadhi. Mahatma Buddha was silent on the existence of the God or otherwise, but he did not believe in the existence of soul. The first Buddhist council was convened after a few years of Buddha's death under the chairmanship of Makkasap in Saptaparna caves near Rajgrih. Mahakashyap. The second Buddhist council was organized at Vaishali. The third Buddhist council was convened at Pataliputra during the regime of Ashoka. The fourth Buddhist council was convened at Kashmir during the regime of Kanishka. Puranas are said to be 18 numbers, of which Bhagavat Purana is very renowned. Bhagavatism is mentioned for the first time in Bhishma Parva of Mahabharata. The Dravida Vaishnava devotees are known as Alvars. A Brahmin named Kautil or Chanak played a significant role in the establishment of the Mauryan Empire. In the Greek writing, Chandragupta Maurya is called as a Sandrokutas. Please do remember this one. Arian and Plutarch have called him Androkutas. In the Mudra Rakshas written by Vishakhadatta, Chandragupta Maurya is called as Chandragiri, Chandrasiri, Chandragiri, Chandrasri. Okay. In Buddhist literature, Mahavansatika is a book which throws ample light on the life of Chandragupta Maurya. Mahavansatika. In Buddhist literature, Indica was written by Megasthenes. In the book Mahavans, Chandragupta Maurya is said to be the Kshatri by caste. After being defeated in the war with Chandragupta, Seleucus Nicator offered him Gadrosia Baluchistan, Acrosia Kandhar, Arya Herat, and part of Hindu Kush. Sudarsham Lake at Junagadh was built by Chandragupta Maurya. Sudarshan Lake at Junagadh was built by Chandragupta Maurya. The Mahasthan inscription points out Chandragupta's ascendancy over Bengal. The Rudra Daman inscription of Girnar testifies to the suzerainty of Chandragupta over Saurashtra. According to Jain text, Chandragupta, in the last years of his life, accepted Jainism and went to Mysore with the Jain monk Bhadrabahu. The empire of Chandragupta spread from Himalaya in the north to Mysore in the south and from Bengal in the east to Baluchistan in the west. It covered Punjab, Sindh, Kashmir, Dwabab Ganga, Yamuna, Magadh, Bengal, Malwa, Saurashtra in the reign of Mysore. The administrative system of Chandragupta Maurya was monarchy. In order to administer well, Chandragupta Maurya appointed a council of ministers. In the Mauryan age, the officer who collected the trade taxes was called as a Sulkadhyaksh. Okay. The chairman of the government services was known as Sutradhyaksh in the Mauryan age. The officer in charge of the weight and measures are known as Pitadhyaksh in the Mauryan age. In the Mauryan age, the officer who controlled the manufacture of wine, its sale and purchase, and its consumption was Suradhyaksh. The chairman of the agriculture department was called as a Sitadhyaksh in Mauryan age. Please remember this one, Sitadhyaksh. There were many officers called as a Ganikadhyaksh, Mudradhyaksh, Navadhyaksh, Ashwadhyaksh, Devtadhyaksh, etc. Mauryan age. The officer who kept the details of total income and expenditure of a state and decided to economic policy was called as a Sannidhata. Under him worked officers like treasurers and sulkadhyaksh. In modern age, the minister of factories and mines was called karmantrik. His main task was to excavate different metals from the mines and look after the factories. In modern age, the amat of fosdari. In modern age, the amat of fosdari criminal court was called pradesh. The amat of the civil court was known as vyavharik. The Greek scholar have described the amatyas as the seventh caste. The successor of Chandragupta Maurya is called named Bindusar in majority of the Puranas. Sironi's works, Buddhist texts, and in Deep Vansh and Mahavansh. In Vayu Puran, his name is given as Bhadrashar. In some of the Puranas, he is called as a Varishar, Bindushar. In the Chinese text, Fawen Chuanlin, he is called as a Bindupal. In another book, Raj Balikath, the successor and son of Chandragupta, is called as a Sinhasin. Ptolemy, the ruler of Egypt, sent Dionysius as his ambassador to the court of Bindushar. So please remember this one. Ptolemy, the ruler of Egypt, sent Dionysius as his ambassador to the court of Bindushar. In Chandragupta Maurya's time, the chief of the city was called as a Nagaradhyaksh, who worked like the modern district magistrate. The smallest unit of administration was the village. Its chief officer was called as a Gramik or a Gramini. Gramini was elected by the people of the village. In every village, there was an officer who was called as a Gram Bhojak. In the administration of Chandragupta Maurya, the department of espiones was well organized. So please remember this one. According to Kautilya, there were two sections of secret service, Sansthan and Sancharana. In the description, Asoka is called as a Devanam Priya and Priyadarshi. The ceremonies, sources and Deep Vansh call him Priyadarshan and Priyadarshi. Scholars think that these were his titles. Ceremonies sources means Sri Lankan sources. Asoka appointed an officer called Mahamatras in every city and districts. In the 13th year of his reign, he appointed Dharma Mahamatra and Dharmayukta for the first time for the happiness and peace of his people. Upagupta was a Buddhist monk of Mathura under his influence. Asoka changed his religion and accepted Buddhism. Asoka sent his daughter Sangamitra and son Mahendra to spread Buddhism in Sri Lanka. His daughter Sangamitra and Mahendra son. In the many edicts, Asoka calls him a Buddha Sakya. Asoka sent Majantik to propagate Buddhism in Kashmir. In 1750, it was Taphentler who first explored the Asokan pillars. Asoka's last edict was found by Baden in 1915 at Muskie. The small edicts of Asoka are of two types. According to Smith, they were written 259 to 232 BC. The first kind of Asokan small pillar edicts are available at Rupnath in Jabalpur district. Sasaram in Sawa district of Bihar, Muskie in Raichur district, and Varat in Rajasthan. The second type of Asokan edicts have been found at Sidhpur, Chitralog, Mysore, Jatig, and Rameshwar and Brahmagiri. The Bhabru edict was found at Bairat near Jaipur in Rajasthan. In this edict, seven precepts of Buddhism have been given, which Asoka liked most, and he desired that the people should read them and make their conduct accordingly. This edict is preserved in Kolkata Museum. Two edicts about Kalinga have been found at Dhauli and Jaugarh. In these, the principles of behavior with the people of Kalinga and with the frontier people have been outlined. Asokan small edicts have been found at about 15 places. The Erangudi edicts was found in Kurnool district of Andhra Pradesh at a place known as Erangudi. The Muskie small edict was found from Muskie village of Raichur district of Andhra Pradesh. It contains the name of Ashoka. The Rasul Mandagiri edict was found on a mound 20 miles beyond Erangudi in Kurnool district of Andhra Pradesh. The Gurjar edict has been found from a village named Gurjar in Datia district of Madhya Pradesh. It was also mentioned the name of Ashoka. Ahurura edict was found from a hill of village Ahurura in Mirzapur district of UP. Palgoria edict was found in 1975. The Sannati inscription edict have been found in the village Sannati in the district of Gulbarg of Karnataka state. The cave inscription are three in number, which have been found in the Barabar hills of Gaya city in Bihar. These refer to the charity performed by the king of Ajivka. The language of Kandahar edict is Greek and Aramaic. The Topra pillar edict have been found from the village named Topra in Haryana. In the courses of the time, Firoz Tughlaq brought it to Delhi, where it is kept at Firoz Shah Kotla ground. Rumindehi small pillar edict was found from Tarai of Nepal. Most of Ashokan edicts are written in Prakrit language. In Gupta age, now let's talk about Gupta age, ships and boats were manufactured in large numbers. Gujarat, Bengal and Tamil Nadu were the main center of cotton industry. Trade between India and China was carried on before Gupta age. In 2nd century, India had trade relations with eastern countries. They were called as a Swarna Bhumi, land of gold. Peshawar, Bharuch, Ujjaini, Varanasi, Prayag, Pataliputra, Mathura, Vaishali and Tamralipti were trade centers. In the west, Bharuch, and in east, Tamralipti were prominent ports. Okay. In the west, Bharuch. In the west side, Bharuch, and in the east side, Tamralipti were the prominent ports. Gold, silver, bronze, tin, camphor, dates, and horses were imported. The collective units of the people who worked in the various industries were known as Kuliks. The Kulik Nigam and Sreeshti Nigam were the unions of wealthy traders. The Kulik Nigam had its own seal, which was used in the commercial correspondence and trade goods. In the Gupta age, India maintained trade relation with Arabia. Horses were imported from Arab and Iran. The seals of Kuliks have been excavated from the town Mita near Allahabad. From Vaishali, 274 seals of Sarthwaha Kulik Nigam have been excavated, prove that it was a great institution of Gupta age. The trade with China, Japan and Sumatra was carried from the port of Tamralipti. In Gupta age, the land tax was known as Udrang. Remember this one. In Gupta age, the land tax was known as Udrang. Kadur and Charpal were the ports situated in the Andhra Pradesh. Kaveri Patnam and Tondai were the ports of Chola state. Kokai and Salyur were the ports of Pandya state. Kottayam and Muzuris were the ports of Malwa state. Sindhu, Orhot, Kalyan and Mibor were the main ports for trade. Hiranya were the tax realized in cash. Bhutvat Pratyay was the tax levied upon the imports from the other countries. So Hiranya were the tax realized in cash. Okay. Haland was the tax charged on the ploughed land. Haldand. A definite portion of the produce from agricultural land was charged on the land tax by the state. It was called as a Bhag tax. Generally, it was charged in kind. In Gupta age, the land was donated only to Brahmins. Okay. So, land was donated only to Brahmins. The land donated to Brahmins was called as a Brahmadeya. So, it was done at the Gupta age. The tax-free village of the Brahmins were called as a Agrahara. Agrahara. In the Gupta age, the Gram Parishads, village councils were autonomous and free from the state control. The uncultivated land was the property of the king. The women who remained unmarried throughout their life and passed their time in studies were called Brahmavadinis. Okay, Brahmavadinis. Takshila, Varanasi and Ujjaini were the prominent center of education. In the Gupta society, intercaste marriages were performed. The slave system was practiced in the Gupta age. The joint family system was in the vogue in Gupta society. The joint family system was prominent during the Gupta's time. In the women, though not as much respected as in the Vedic period, it enjoyed important position in the society of Gupta age. So condition of women got deteriorated during Gupta time. Seal Bhatrika was an educated and worthy woman of Gupta age. So please remember this name, Seal Bhatrika. Widow remarries were performed in the Gupta age, but some books of the age speak against it. Chandragupta II married the widow of Ramagupta, his brother. Her name was Dhruva Swamini. Okay. Prostitutes, expert in music and dance, and perfect in sexology were called as a Ganikas. The traders and commercial professionals had their srinis in Gupta age. The Patkar, Telik, oil traders, means Telik. Pashan Kotak, stone cutters, very important srinis. The author of Swapna Vasavaduttam was the eminent prose writer. The author of Bhatikavya or Ravanvadh was Bhatti. The author of Bhatikavya or Ravanvadh was Bhatti, an eminent poet of Gupta age. Bharthari wrote Neeti Shatak, Srinagar Shatak and Vairagya Shatak, which became very famous. Some scholars believe that Bharthari is another name for Bhatti. Kuntaleshwar Daityam is a drama that testifies to the fact that Kalidas belonged to the Gupta age. Kuntaleshwar Daityam. Abhigyan Sakuntalam, Meghadut, Ritu Samhar are some of the major works of Kalidas. Kamasutra is a famous book on sexology written by Vatsyayana. It was written during the Gupta time. Vaibhashik and Sangbhadra were the two acharyas, teachers of the Gupta age, who wrote the literature of the Vaibhashik sect. So that's all for ancient India. In the next video, I will come up with medieval India. So please do not forget to watch the next video, especially of medieval India. I will compile entire thing within a prescribed time frame. So please watch the medieval India. And for that, you need to subscribe the channel, and so that you can get the notification. That's all for now. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Take care. God bless you.